My cooch riflet.
Vroom vroom.
Hey Hitches, welcome to episode 5 of the Hall Monitor. Today we're going to find out who won our t-shirt Twitter contest. But first, let's jump right into things and see this What's in My Bag video from the makeup station.
Today I'm going to be doing a What's in My Purse video for you guys. I actually got this for Christmas for my husband, so it was really...
Okay, look, I respect she has a husband and everything, but I'm having a hard time concentrating on what she's saying. I mean, look at those eyes.
Oh gosh, I have to get a key, like one of those custom keys that have those designs.
I can't stop staring at those eyes. They're mesmerizing. I mean, it's like they're putting me in a trance or something. Last time I met a girl with eyes like this, she duped me out of 300 bucks. Yeah, I mean, I guess I can't feel too bad because, you know, she was going to college. She had a kid. She was just doing this job temporarily until she moved on to bigger and better things and kind of reached her aspirations.
I just love this purse. I mean, it's huge.
Damn right it's huge. It's f***ing enormous. I mean, look at the size of that thing. I mean, can you even call something a purse when it gets that big? It's more like a vessel or something, or like a West End apartment.
And then in here I have my cooch wristlet, and I just basically carry my cash and stuff like that in there.
Excuse me?
I have my cooch.
Okay, maybe I got something in my ear, but I think what she means to say is coach.
Cooch.
Yeah, I'm definitely hearing something else there. Okay, so on to our t-shirt contest winner. The cool thing is we actually had more than one person enter this time, unlike our last t-shirt contest where we literally had one person enter. It's sad because it's true. But like I said, we had more than one person this time. Sadly, most of the entries sucked, like these. Check out these cute men who love makeup videos. Epic. Cute? Nobody likes a liar, Brenda. I look in the mirror every morning, and cute is not looking back. The Hall blog is funny as fudge, and they have a contest to win their cool shirts. First of all, we're giving away one shirt. Singular. Second of all, nothing is as funny as fudge. Although I do like your Run DMC shirt. I totally want one of those shirts from Hall blog. Yeah? Well, I want more subscribers. Looks like we're both out of luck. We've also got some kind of decent entries, like this. Only posting Hall blog for the free t-shirt contest. And their videos are pretty cool too. Pick me. Well, I do appreciate your honesty. I gotta say, a little reverse psychology could have gone a long way with this one. Love your videos. You guys are like the web guru version of The Soup. Epic. XOX. Again, I like this one. Especially since it's probably the closest I'll ever get to a girl actually kissing and hugging me. But in the end, it all boiled down to these two tweets. You said something gross, Hall blog. Here you go.
Oh my god.
Oh my god, did you see how it started like bubbling up in his mouth as it started filling up? Ugh, that was gross. Bummer for you, a coworker of mine sent me that same exact video 2 days before you did, and I didn't have to give him a t-shirt for it. So, the winning entry actually came from Tare, who tweeted, "A skirt is like a good tweet, long enough to cover the essentials, but short enough to create interest." Well, I do like short skirts, so congratulations, Tare. That was a lot of buildup for nothing. Getting back onto the show, let's see what Mr. Xander James has been up to lately.
This is going to be my liquid foundation routine. I kind of use this as kind of like a ghetto kabuki. So, you know, just kind of swirl it around in there. Tap it off. And then just swirl it in.
So, Xander here is only the second guy I've ever featured on the show. It's true. The first guy was Avidio Lewis back in episode 2. Now, I know what you're probably thinking. How come every time Joey Mack features a dude, he's got to be gay? Well, I didn't feature the first guy because he was gay. I featured him because he was black. What? I mean, Look, if I'm proud of one thing, it's this show does not discriminate. Besides, some of my best friends are Asian.
So I'll just take one full pump out of my hand.
Okay, so setting aside what he said, there's still no way of really knowing if he's gay or not. Besides, there's a ton of guys out there that wear makeup that aren't gay. Case in point. I think you get the idea. Wait, what's that? Neil Patrick, really?
Yeah, just this blue plain sweater, the white zipper, and then this shirt that you've seen before.
Nope, still doesn't prove a thing.
I got a big metal pole, a little one, you know, the boring days.
Did he just wink?
So I have this amazing cup you guys are gonna love. Or maybe hate, but if you don't love it, then whatever, you're weird. Or I'm weird for loving it. So, it's like this giant cup, right? It's kind of like one of those old John cups. See, it's like so big, and it has like all the bling on it. Okay, yeah, well, there's one more thing. Bam! It says gangster.
All right, now we're talking. You see how sick that cup is? Personally, I think the verdict is still out. Well, that will do it for this episode. Be sure to follow us on Twitter and Facebook. Also want to say thanks to everybody who's left us a voicemail message. We love getting voicemail. So if you haven't called us up yet, feel free to do so. And lastly, on a serious note, apparently my writers are a little bit bummed out that I always have stuff going on during the credit roll. You know, something about not getting recognition, blah, blah, blah. I really, you know, I don't know. But look, I won't be offended if you guys close out of the browser, because let's be honest, credit rolls are boring.